So good afternoon, everybody. We just finished up our weekly leadership meeting, and before we take questions, I just wanted to inform you all on a couple of updates. First of all, and we talked upstairs with the Senate President and the Speaker of the House about this, we're announcing a $10 million small business recovery loan fund for small businesses impacted by COVID-19. This fund should sound familiar to those of you who covered either the snow emergencies in 15 or the Merrimack Valley disasters in 18. The fund will provide emergency capital of up to $75,000 for Massachusetts businesses with under 50 full-time and part-time employees, and that does include nonprofits. Loans are available immediately with no payments due for the first 6 months. The Massachusetts Growth Capital Corporation has capitalized the fund and will administer it. And to apply, businesses can complete application on the Growth Capital Fund's website, empoweringsmallbusiness.org, and email completed applications to mgcc@massgcc.com with the subject line 2020 Small Business Recovery Loan Fund. Earlier today, the MBTA also announced scheduling revisions that will be effective starting tomorrow, March 17th. These changes are being made based on the guidance they got from public health professionals and have been developed according to several criteria that seek to protect the health and safety of MBTA employees and customers, as well as recent reductions in ridership. This will include schedule changes for light rail, reduced schedule for the commuter rail, and a Saturday schedule for some, but not for all of the bus routes. Ferry service has been canceled, and the ride will continue to run a full service. For more information on this, riders should visit www.mbta.com/coronavirus. I do want to repeat a couple of the things we said yesterday. As everybody knows, we're working this issue around the clock to mitigate the spread of this disease and to make sure we're taking all steps we can to support our workforce and the core functions of state government that will continue to operate. And as you may recall, last night, Lieutenant Governor Polito and I announced a series of emergency actions to keep our residents and communities safe during this time. This includes the three-week suspension of school operations for educational purposes at all public and private elementary and secondary K-12 schools in the Commonwealth beginning tomorrow, March 17th. A three-week prohibition of gatherings of 25 people or more and prohibiting on-premises consumption of food or drink at bars and restaurants. Instructing all non-emergency state employees from the executive branch not to report to work today and tomorrow unless they are essential to the state's coronavirus response efforts. Requiring all commercial insurers and the Group Insurance Commission to cover medically necessary telehealth services in the same manner that they cover in-person services, prohibiting visitors to long-term care facilities, and requesting hospitals cancel all elective surgeries. And as we announced last night, today we filed legislation that will allow new claimants for unemployment benefits to be paid more quickly by waiving the one-week waiting period. There's no question everybody's feeling the impact of the coronavirus at this point, and it is certainly tremendously disruptive to our daily lives. Whether your kids are home from school or you're going to miss grabbing a meal at your favorite neighborhood restaurant this weekend, we're all adjusting to these circumstances. But I think it's important to remember why. Our public health professionals believe by taking these serious actions now, we can mitigate the spread of coronavirus and help protect our most vulnerable population. According to healthcare experts, the vast majority of the people who get this disease, around 80%, will experience seasonal flu-like symptoms. But for older adults and those with issues, this can be a very serious illness. So please do your best to cooperate with the guidance that's been issued, practice social distancing, and practice good personal hygiene. And remember to keep surfaces clean, wash your hands, and stay home if you're not feeling well. And finally, there are many rumors and false information floating around out there. Please remember to get your information from credible sources like mass.gov/coronavirus. We'll continue to post new information and updates there for everyone to keep you informed and to help you plan ahead. It's very important that everybody maintain what I would describe as a level head for the next few months as we work our way through this. That, in some respects, is our greatest opportunity to be successful.